What's going on, Rushers?
What's going on, Rushers?
What's going on, Rushers?
What's going on, Rushers?
You're watching.
You're watching.
You're watching.
You are watching.
Stage Rush.
Stage Rush.
Stage Rush.
Stage Rush.
Stage Rush.
TV.
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 Well, they all said it better than I could. This is a very special edition of Stage Rush TV because I have two of my friends with me, Georgina and Kym. And we are here at Vassar College for the Powerhouse Theater. We are seeing on a clear day, you can see forever, directed by Michael Mayer, starring Brian D'Arcy James and Anika Noni Rose. And we are all very excited to be here because this is our third year coming. This is kind of a tradition that we've done, and that's why we had the special intro from my friends, and I thank you them very much for filming that for me. This is definitely a special intro because it's my birthday, and this is, I'm 24 years old, and
happy
this
birthday!
Is, thank you! And do you know this is actually the 24th episode of Stage Rush TV?
Aww. Oh my gosh!
And
you couldn't have even planned it better.
I couldn't have planned it better myself.
No, good job.
So here we are, this is our third year doing Powerhouse in a row.
In a row.
But not our third year being friends.
No, definitely not. But it's just become a natural tradition. It started because we our first year, 2 years ago, we saw, or was it 3 years ago, technically?
2 years.
2 years ago, we saw Nero, written by Steven Sater and Duncan Cheek. Mm-hmm. And we saw it because we loved Spring Awakening, and so we wanted to see another musical of theirs. Right. And also it was because Lea Michele was in it. Mm-hmm. And that was what drew us here. And then after that, what was it last year? And then we saw Whisper House, so it was more Duncan Cheek. And then we're here this year because Michael Mayer's directing. Mm-hmm. And we do happen to love Brian D'Arcy James, and a lot of people love Anika Noni Rose. But I think it all stems from Spring Awakening, our love for Spring
it
Awakening.
Does. Yeah.
So anyway, that's kind of started it, but it's become, it started with like kind of like a love for Spring Awakening and seeing that, and then, but then it just became a tradition because there are cool projects here every year, and we just like want to come every year and see something.
Mm-hmm. I feel fortunate to be a part of it. It's such a great experience.
What's your favorite thing about the Powerhouse shows?
I just feel like that it's such a personal theater, and it's such a, you just feel like you're so close because it's just a very welcoming and, you know, culture theater. I feel like it's very...
No, it was good. I feel the same way.
Yeah, I just feel like it's a very personal, intimate setting, and it's a really nice...
I like that too.
Yeah.
I feel like the personal thing, like I like, it's that intimate setting, but you get to see like some big stars. Mm-hmm. Like there weren't any in Whisper House last year, but right. We saw Lea Michele for Nero right before she went to LA to film Glee.
Right.
And of course that blew up. And what was
Idina
so cool
Menzel
about that,
too.
Idina Menzel was in that. And so
I love
that was
that.
When, I mean, I'm not positive, but I think that's kind of when they first worked together and
yeah.
met.
Mm-hmm.
And then they go on to do Glee
right.
and play mother and daughter. I mean, mm-hmm. so, and that was in such an intimate setting and we saw them.
I
right
feel like
that.
It was almost like felt unreal. That we were just so close to them in such a small setting, it just didn't seem right because they were such big names
yeah.
with, you know, us there.
What do you like most cool. about it?
I think I like, it's such an interesting way to see theater. I mean, you know, there's workshops all the time, but how many people get to go to them in this early stage? And we get to do it every year, and every year we know we have something like this to look forward to. And sometimes the shows don't really go anywhere, but when they do... It's kind of cool to be
yeah.
able to say you were there in the beginning.
Well, it's interesting because this is actually the first show we're seeing that we know is getting a
yeah,
full stage because
right.
it's set to play at the Vineyard Theater in January.
Yeah.
So that's going to be kind of weird, almost like a different watching it tonight,
right.
knowing that it's you know you can see a full-fledged production of it soon.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing I liked was that it's just very vulnerable. Like, you're seeing them in a vulnerable state, mm. and it's not like their perfect performance.
Because
flaws.
Things happen.
Right.
I mean, it's always live theater, things can happen, but this is like, it's more... Well, we had an interesting thing because for Nero... We actually did not come on the same night.
Right.
Gio came the night before us just because of the scheduling conflict, and then we saw it the next night. What happened with Idina Menzel when she was doing one of her big scenes in Nero?
Okay, so this is what happened. Scene starts, it's like very serious tone, and then she starts like getting ready to speak. This is not my script. And like then everyone bursts into laughter. It was just so funny because she just goes, "This is not my script." And we just loved it. It was just so funny because it was so unlike planned and just really, you know, made it even better.
I mean, I guess maybe she just simply couldn't have gone on, but the fact that she was brave enough to actually say, like, I'm sorry.
This is not my script. Like, she just said, this is not my script. And then they actually, like, paused, you know, and got her
But what's really funny, in addition to that, is that the next night when we saw it then, same scene, Kym, what happens?
Well, it's a very intense scene, like Gio said, and she's kind of... making a lot of exclamations about all the riches, I guess, that are around her. I don't remember exactly what the context was, but there's a scene where she's talking about her necklace, and when we saw it, she went to grab her necklace, and she ripped it. And I'm sure anyone can imagine the sound that, like, 1,000 little beads make when they hit
because
the
they're reading the scripts, and she's got one of those wooden, no, not wooden, metal.
It was like a metal.
Music stands in front of her, and the beads just hit it. It was like, and she didn't see. Now she's like broke character for you, and but like she was pushed through this one. But it was funny because you could tell she was like,
and see it in her eyes. Like,
I thought that was hilarious. So yeah, it's exciting. You don't know what's gonna happen because they're reading off scripts, and
I love that.
And they're not that rehearsed. I mean, they were like, we've learned 15 songs in a weekend, I remember they said once.
They were clearly using, they needed the scripts, you know?
Gio, you mentioned something to me last year after we saw Whisper House when it was done. You turned to me. I really thought that I liked this, and it kind of summed up the experience for me, too. But you said, you turned to me and you said you felt so cultured after doing this.
I think I felt like, you know, for such a small group of people to be a part of it on such a beautiful campus, and I feel like it's just a really great experience. Like I said, very intimate, and I just feel like it's not something that I'm a part of very often, so I feel like when I was there for that, it just made me realize that I'm part of this like elite group, and not many people know about it, and it's just
not many people know. And it's like we've traveled far
amazing.
To see, and we see stuff on Broadway in New York, even off Broadway, but it's all in New York all the time.
Yeah.
We've come out to Poughkeepsie, New York, to see this. I mean, not like
I know.
Not that it's not that there's things. Isn't any things outside of New York, but it's just like we've come so far.
But now
to see
that
this.
We know about it, we will keep seeing.
Yeah,
it. That's the thing. And now I feel like we're a part of that, and I wouldn't want to miss it.
But you know what I think is cool is that we travel so far, but obviously like the people that are involved travel so far to come out here. Like we've had some really
that's
good
true.
Sightings.
Yeah.
2 years. Well, the first 2 years we came here, we went to this had dinner at this restaurant, Beechtree Cafe.
Mm-hmm. Best.
Really good food,
ever.
By the way.
Please. Really good.
And the first year, I mean. We walked, we're sitting there, and Duncan Sheik and Steven Sater walk in. Mm-hmm. And I pretty much dropped all my silverware.
Yeah,
this is true.
But we did go up to them, and we had them sign some stuff, and they couldn't have been nicer. But that was just, this was before the show, though. So we're already in anticipation of the show. We were hoping we'd see them in the theater, and they walk in. We also saw Lily Cooper at that performance.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And the next year, though, at the same restaurant, we saw Duncan Sheik. Duncan Sheik came
again.
In.
Yep.
Again, very next
that
year for Whisper House.
It's clearly a regular.
So maybe we'll
like
see him this year, I mean, to support Michael Mayer.
Yeah.
Maybe.
What happened when we were on the train back from Nero?
Oh, well, unfortunately, I don't remember the actor's name, but he was very good. The actor who played Nero was actually on the same train with us, and we talked to him for a minute, so that was kind of cool.
But didn't he say, it was? We were like, great job, and he was like, I'm just not.
Yeah, he didn't think he did very well.
No, his voice was gone.
Oh, yeah.
He's like, thank you, but I can't talk, so thank you. He just was like, I'm going to wave and walk on.
Yes.
Good excuse.
Yeah, right? Really. He just didn't want to talk to
you,
actually.
You.
These people need to leave me alone right now.
So we're extremely excited for this performance, and we'll let you know how it goes.
It's going to be awesome.
So I just wanted to say quickly thank you for everyone who played in the Little Night Music Promises Promises ticket giveaway. The winners have been selected, and congratulations to the four winners, and continue to look for more giveaways yet to come. Moving on to some Broadway grosses, Billy Elliot sold 99% of its tickets last week.
Come Fly Away sold 49%.
Million Dollar Quartet sold 56%.
Oh, and Come Fly Away, by the way, posted its closing notice, which I'm not surprised about. And you said that Million Dollar Quartet sold 56, and I think they're going to be the next
probably
one.
Probably on its way.
But I really want to see that.
Well, maybe you should go see South Pacific instead, which sold 97%
okay.
of the tickets. But they're closing in August. But it's funny because
they don't have to close, though.
No, they don't.
They
weren't selling well for a while, a long while, and then they announced that it was closing, and now it's selling 97%,
of
which
course.
I guess all the supporters, people who really loved it, are coming out for one last viewing.
One last time.
Right.
Interesting. Well, thank you so much for tuning into this special episode of Stage Rush TV. And thank you for my special guests for being here.
Thanks,
thank
Jess.
You for having us. Thank I feel you. So honored that I'm a part of
it. And happy
Absolutely.
Birthday.
Thank you very much.
Happy birthday.
Well, thanks for watching.
Old man.
Have a great week at the theater.
Yep. Bye.
Can you smell what the rush is cooking?